The flash floods assessment report indicates a number of households destroyed, with 1,575, at least 22 schools were affected, with others deroofed, while walls of other schools cracked. The specific number of classrooms affected are 40, with blown-off roofs and cracks on the wall. At least 10 worship houses were destroyed with blown-off roofs and cracks on the walls. The community lost 480 houses, which were totally destroyed, while 527 houses were partially destroyed. Under the health sector, the floods destroyed 5 health facilities, whose roofs were blown off while others developed cracks on the walls. Meanwhile, 575 latrines were totally destroyed and collapsed, and 102 retail shops and kiosks were submerged. Others were blown by the wind. The flash floods left a number of roads washed, submerged, and culverts carried off.
A total of about 1,557 households were affected in our city, as we came up with the report. The number of people who were affected were about 8,294. Then 450 acres were covered by flood, that is for the entire district.
Office of the Prime Minister has come up to support the affected persons with food items and tarpaulins for the most vulnerable and needy persons.
Received relief food. And then non-relief food. About 13,000 kilograms of maize flour was received from the office of the Prime Minister, which were safely kept in our stores.
Fred Okumu, the brand's manager, Arua Uganda Red Cross Society, said Madiokolo received much rains, which affected a number of households, and Red Cross sent a team to support the district in assessment. Okumu advises the district to maintain an active district contiguous plan, which will guide them during emergency.
All districts, more or less, those are disaster prone, to ensure that they have contiguous plans, district contiguous plans, fully approved by Office of the Prime Minister, and must also have district disaster management committees.
The LC5 chairman, Madiokolo Ismail Drabe, said 2023 was a year of destruction which affected the people. The chairman cites a number of roads destroyed, which makes travel difficult.
Clearly, isolate the category of people who are supposed to get them, and this includes the widows, the sick, the old, the child-headed families, and those families headed by HIV people, and also persons with disabilities. We shall try to go by this, and it is my belief that not all of them will suitably get the food ration.
Our role as leadership is to give the community, the people under your care, hope that there can still be life after this, and that what has happened is not in the past.
The district will give out the food items after selecting the most affected and vulnerable persons. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.